Hey guys, so I've been using Infensia's fantastic new Pixpel palette for a little while now, and I've been having issues exporting from Blender and importing into Godot. In this video, I want to explain why the issue exists and demonstrate a method I've come up with for making the import process a whole lot easier. So what have I got here? I have two assets, a bus stop and a bin. Both are using the Pixpel material you can see in the materials panel on the right. If I tab into edit mode, you can see in the UV window on the left, the wood parts I have in the wood section of the texture and the metal parts I have in the dull section. Same for the bin, it's all metal and it's all in the dull part. So why does Blender have an issue exporting? Well, if we head over to the shading tab, we can see all of this right here. GLTF doesn't really have a way of exporting these custom nodes, so it kind of guesstimates. And we end up with just this BSDF with these textures attached. And when we import into Godot, things don't look quite right as a result. So how can we get around this issue? Well, let's head over to Godot and take a look. So here we are in Godot with a blank project. I've just created a demo scene and added a world environment and a directional light. I have my bin and bus stop GLTFs exported from Blender. If I drag them into the scene, we can immediately see the bin has some incorrect colors. That's because by default, the textures are imported with VRM compression on. They need to be uncompressed. But the much bigger issue is that our bus stop is very reflective. See the wood paneling? See how reflective it is? Now, one potential way of solving this issue is by using the Infensia material for Godot. That can be downloaded off of the Infensia website or my GitHub repo. If we open up the bus stop GLTF and search for the Infensia Pixpel material, we can use external here, check that, and then search for the Infensia material. Click re-import, and our bus stop is immediately looking a lot better. Do the same for the bin. And the bin is also fixed. Now this works fine if you have two assets, but what happens if you have 200 or 500? Double clicking on the GLTF, searching for the material and enabling external material doesn't really scale very well. It would be much better if we could automate this process. Here we have the same blank demo scene, but this time with my Pixpel Tools add-on. Once you've dropped it into your project, go Project, Project Settings, Plugins, and enable it. Now, if we Alt-Tab back to Blender and export our two GLTFs and back into Godot, you should be able to see everything just imports without any sort of manual intervention. So how does this work? If I enable editable children on one of these objects, and I look into the mesh and the surface object, you can see here the path for the material is coming from the Pixpel Tools add-on. It's not the standard material that we would have had if we hadn't installed the plugin. And we haven't used external here. So if I open up the plugin and we take a look, I'm using an Editor Scene Post Import plugin where I iterate through every node in an imported scene. If I find a mesh on one of those mesh instances ending with the word Pixpel, I set the material to the material in our add-on. It really is that simple. You can now import hundreds of assets into Godot from Blender and they'll all just automatically have the correct material applied. This doesn't need to be restricted to Pixpel. You can use it with any material. You'll just need to update the material and update the code here. And there's not a lot more to say about this one. It's a very small plugin that does one job very well. If you liked this video, then like, comment, subscribe, and have a wonderful day.